everybody. Hi, welcome to Senior Spotlight. I'm Debbie Travis, Assistant Director, and I'm here with...
My name is Erica Pauly, the new Recreation Coordinator. Hi. For events and programs, not fitness.
Well, I mean, we do like special events, yes, in a fitness world too, but Erica is your girl. If you've got any suggestions or you want to see anything at the Senior Center, Erica, well, really any of us, but Erica's going to be... overseeing that for the most part, so we're super excited and honored to have her on board. So today we're going to be talking about April special events, mainly at the Senior Center. If you are a member, you probably know that there are ongoing activities happening all the time. Fitness classes.
There's always something.
Programs. We're playing cards. We're playing ping pong. Sports crafts. So many things are happening. But what we're going to talk about are the special events that we'll need you to register for to save your seat, for the most part. And I just want to start off with our walking club. So I think we've talked about the walking club before. I get to lead this. It's very exciting for me. At 8:45 in the morning, for about a half an hour, we'll walk around our campus. We've been using Nordic poles, which are, they help engage your upper body while you're walking, and they also offer support while you're walking. We do have our snow picks on the bottom of them, so we'll see if we can bring it out.
For
if
now.
If there's any snow happening in April, well, there won't be. But, okay, we'll just cross over that. but in April, beginning in April, an added surprise with our walking club, we are going to be getting free pedometers. So, Erica, do you have a pedometer? Have you ever used one?
I've used one. I have a watch that it'll track my steps.
Okay.
And a lot of phones now, if you don't have a pedometer, but you keep your phone in your purse, your pocket, yeah, it'll kind of estimate about how many steps you're taking. But these are really great.
We're going to clip these onto our belts or our pants or whatever, and it's going to let us know how many steps we took during that walking stint. And then beyond, of course, because you get to take them home and use them, you know, in any capacity of your walking. What do they say, about 10,000 steps?
Yeah.
Keeps you strong and healthy. So that's always the goal. We appreciate those pedometers, and they're brought in by Wellbridge of Romeo. So we thank them for that. So join me walking 8:45 to 9:15 every Tuesday, weather permitting. Next up will be April 5th, and we're going to have a Health Matters segment. So Health Matters is presented quarterly in cooperation with Henry Ford Macomb Hospital and Dignity Memorial. And we bring in huge, relevant topics of how to stay healthy. The topic coming up on April 5th is opioids, the silent epidemic, and how to combat it. There'll be a complimentary lunch, and we're going to be talking about the opioid epidemic. A lot of people were prescribed opioids. They're very tough to kick. Mainly addressing pain. So how do we, you know, deal with that pain if we are not taking these opioids anymore? Henry Ford Macomb is going to come in, give us some alternatives to how to get off of opioids and how to still manage our pain in a healthier way. So please join us 11:30 to 1 o'clock. You'll also get a healthy lunch. That is complimentary. We'll need you to register. Limited seats. Wednesday, April 6th. This might be a way to help kick opioids, and it's with breath work. So we have a breath work specialist coming in. He's going to show us different ways of breathing, purposeful breathing, that will help kind of re-gauge or reset your physiological, whatever might be giving you stress, anxiety, ADHD, chronic other illnesses could be reset by the way we do purposeful breathing. And we're going to learn this in 4-week sessions beginning April 6th. April 6th is a complimentary class at 10 o'clock, but then we're going to offer it in May and June in 4-week sessions. So that'll be $20 for a 4-week session, $5 a class. I think you're really going to love to have this in your arsenal of healthy ways to combat pain and anxiety, stress, all that stuff.
Take the time to focus on you for a little bit and kind of just take a step back and slow down. And
I've got a few people forward. I would want to refer this to, like, hello, I think you need this.
Me?
No,
I'm one of them.
Not you, Erica.
We all
not
need you. It. I think it's a good thing for everyone.
It is. It's good to have and to know that you can do something about a situation immediately. No drugs, drug-free. Yeah. So, yeah, please join us for that.
So our next big program that I love, dear to my heart, those Tigers are going to be back at it on April 8th. It's a Friday game. It's our home opener.
Yeah.
So I know a lot of us, we don't really have the time to go down to Comerica Park to see that game, but we're going to bring the stadium right here to Clinton Township in our gymnasium. Kim Meltzer, she's going to be there. She is our county clerk.
Township
clerk.
For now.
And she's going to be bringing snacks and hot dogs. They're the best ones in town. So you want to make sure that you register for that one. There's also going to be ice cream. So if you don't like hot dogs, you don't like snacks, I don't know too many people who don't like those.
I think it's going to be a great, I mean, just whatever you sort of expect from Comerica when you go. I mean, yep. I love the Tigers, but I mean, I really go for the hot dogs. I got to tell you. So the things that you come to expect for the most part at the stadium, we'll be in our pseudo stadium that day, thanks to Kim Meltzer, our township clerk. She may end up being the county clerk someday, but I don't know. Right now, she's at the township level.
So wear your Tigers gear, bring your favorite lawn chair with you. We do have our chairs available if you don't have a lawn chair, but they're not as comfortable.
Right.
You don't get the whole vibe.
Yeah, we want you relaxed, comfortable.
So bring your own chair. We're going to start that program. The gym's going to open up at noon. The game starts at about 1 o'clock. It's a 1:10 start time. So make sure if you have any dietary restrictions, you can always pack your own snacks and bring those along with
you,
too.
Absolutely. Yep. So that's going to be fun. Looking forward to that. Next, I think we're going to talk about
asking the expert again. Henry Ford Macomb Hospital is going to be joining us again. They come the second Tuesday of the month to discuss some very good health questions, health concerns, as well as trends that are happening in the health community as it relates to older adults.
Very much so.
As well as everybody. So a lot of the content that they bring is just good to know.
It is.
So you can ask your questions if you have any questions regarding that topic as well. You do need to pre-register for this program so they kind of know how many people are going to be attending that day. So you can always stop by the front desk the next time you're in. Give them a call, let them know. These are always good sensitive issues that you may experience, may not, but it's always good to have the knowledge of what might be coming around the corner.
You know, and you bring up a good point, Erica, too, because I was talking about something to somebody and they're like, I don't really know that I need that. I'm like, you know what, though? To know about it makes you a very valuable friend to share with someone who might want to know about a topic that you just learned some interesting information on. Yeah. So we do love that you come to that, and it's pretty popular, and we love Henry Ford Macomb for sharing their specialists with us and having them come in to visit us.
Yeah, so that's the second Tuesday of the month from 10 to 11, so make sure you get that on your calendar.
Very nice.
A reoccurring program, so if you do miss the April one, you can always join us for the next one.
The week of April 11 to 15, we're going to be celebrating Fitness Appreciation Week. So we have some fitness instructors who have just been absolute sweethearts all through COVID and beyond. They've been there for us, keeping us in shape, healthy, giving us the strength we need to get through these crazy pandemics and beyond. They were streaming through our cable station when we were closed up in our senior center. And I know that they have a lot of love that supports them too through our members. So we really want to tip our hat to them. The week of April 11 to the 15th, we're going to put out special things that week too. And we hope that you also will write your love notes to them and be especially mindful and appreciative of them this week, that we just kind of raise them up and give them a huge hug of thanks.
Because we should always be thanking them for being there.
We do adore them. Yeah, sometimes, you know, we're in our busyness, but
that little extra something special.
They deserve it.
They've been
dolls for us. Okay, on Wednesday, April 13, we're going to have our April Lunch and Learn, Erica, and we're going to be providing a complimentary lunch through the support of Comfort Keepers Home Care and Oakmont Parkway Senior Community. The topic is going to be critical race theory explained in plain terms. So Do you know much about critical race theory? Like, I know a broad brush, you know, about it, but not enough to really discuss it with somebody.
That's where I'm at, in the same boat. That's why I'm really excited to be going to this program and actually attending this one, because critical race theory is something that's not going away. It's something that's, we all should be aware of this topic and this issue and be able to form educated opinions on what we feel and be fully educated before we make those opinions.
Definitely. And you say educated. We couldn't get more educated than being taught this topic by a professor. And we have a delightful professor coming in from the University of Toledo. Professor Mungo is going to deliver what critical race theory is about, how his race shaped our society, and perhaps public policy as well. So she's going to share that stuff with us. We'll be armed with a lot more knowledge to have discussions on it and, like you say, form better opinions on it. 11 o'clock to 1:30. And I think that following the presentation, too, we might show a short movie. It should be totally riveting, you guys. So please do register for this Wednesday, April 13. You will enjoy it.
Okay, and then on Thursday, the 14th of April, Robert Cannon, Clinton Township Supervisor, will be joining us with some coffee and some sweet treats. He lately has been bringing in some other township departments, offices, to kind of give everyone the go-to, what's happening in the community, and things that you should be aware of as residents of Clinton Township. Yeah. It's open to the public. We do need you to pre-register, though, so that way we know how many treats to bring for everyone, so everyone can indulge in in that as we all listen and get the new happenings. That starts at 10 a.m., and that happens every other month.
Just about. Bob will visit us every other month and give us the updates of the township. We've got a lot of great things that are always booming in the township, and I know it's always interesting to hear what Bob has to say, too.
And it's a great time to answer and have your questions answered.
For sure.
So if you have a question that's been kind of in the back of your mind and you don't know who to ask or when to ask, it's a great time to bring those questions.
Yep, yep, to Mr. Cannon. Tuesday, April 19, we'll have Brain Fitness, you guys. So Brain Fitness happens every month for the most part. That's on the third Tuesday of the month, starting at 9:30 to about 11 o'clock. Marshall Relia is from CARE, and she delivers an amazing program of the latest and greatest of how to keep our brains sharp. And Erica was just a in the audience of our latest Brain Fitness class. And I know she came away with a lot of great takeaways, too. Would you recommend this class, Erica?
100%. Even if you think that you are the sharpest tack in the board, I would definitely recommend it. Just to walk away with some new activities. You always get some handouts. But she also covers different types of brain-related topics as it comes to brain health and overall health and fitness, where it comes down to what's functioning in your brain and how it's happening and why it's happening, and to kind of go through really the changes that happens as you age in your brain. So it kind of brings you back down to knowing, okay, this is normal, and what can I do to kind of keep my brain as fit as I can for as long as I can.
I know, just even talking to my mom, who's 86 right now, and she'll say, oh my gosh, you know, my memory. And she'll give me an example. I'm like, Mom, actually, that's better than what I would remember right now. And I think that's just normal aging. It's nothing to be concerned about. So if you're looking to be proactive, this is the class that you want to attend, because there are things you can do to help, you know, push that decline. At bay. And in fact, I was looking up, like, what are some of the things we can do just on our own? Drive a new route home. Don't go home the same way. Go a different way. Don't get lost, but, you know, take a different route. Play crossword puzzles. I think that's a common one. Everybody knows that. Playing chess definitely keeps those neurons firing. Learn a new musical instrument.
Yep.
So, okay, plug. We're doing keyboard lessons at the Senior Center, you guys. Check it out. Play a new sport.
We've always got intro to some sort of sport
going
on.
We have sports going constantly. Learn a foreign language. little trickier.
A little
but,
trickier.
You know, if you follow it up with a reward to that country, that would be fun. Cook a new cuisine. So I did just do this recently to where we ordered one of those like kits that come into your house. And it did introduce me to like these different spices, this different technique. So that was fun. Do chores with your eyes closed. So that really keeps you, you have to be so aware of what's going on when you're like washing a dish, like you'll be feeling it.
Yeah.
Like, is there any residue or whatever? But that actually builds different neurons.
Just don't do it around the stairs.
Okay, good tip. Thank you, Erica.
Nobody needs to be going down the stairs blindfolded.
Switch hands. Yeah. So when you're eating, you know, eat with your other hand or brushing your teeth. That's one too that's kind of common, but how often do I do it even though I know it? Brush your teeth with your other hand, you guys. Every day, every morning, morning and night, at least two or three times a day, try that and you'll find that it's a little difficult at first, but you'll pick up the hang of it. And then practice meditation. To have a clean, quiet mind and get all that noise out of the background helps us to remember things and walk a little more purposefully through our day. So those are just some tips I looked up and like, what can we do on our own to be sharp, stay sharp, and good luck. Good luck, everyone. Okay, next up, spring. Okay, April, spring. What do you think of when you think spring, Erica?
You got the birds chirping. Yeah. The robins are coming back.
Yeah, happy, happy, happy.
Happy. Everyone's in a better mood.
For
the
sure.
snow is hopefully gone or going away.
Well, we're in Michigan, so that's not a definite guarantee. One of the things that I'm not always super excited about when it comes to spring is spring cleaning. But it's, you know, one of those things that I feel like should be done. But the sweethearts at Oak Street Health are going to make it so much more delightful for us. They're going to come in. It's called Spring Fling. And on Tuesday, April 19, they are going to bring in their cleaning kits for us, complimentary cleaning kits, as well as lunch. And they're going to give us some cleaning tips on how to streamline that chore list. I can't think of a better way to do spring cleaning than with these accessories.
Right.
So we just love that.
Makes it a lot easier. You've already got you're provided the tools. So you just need to put them to use.
It's almost fun. Like if you have a new sponge, it almost makes it fun. Tuesday, April 19, 11:30 to 12:30. Don't miss it. Limited seats on that. So please call ahead.
I've got another limited seats opportunity here for you. Bike basket. Basket weaving. Basket weaving.
Okay.
So that will be from 9:30 to 12:30. It's a two-part class. So it's 2 days. So it's Thursday, April 21st and the 28th. You have to attend both of those. Otherwise, your basket will only be half. You'll have half a basket.
I know some people like that already.
So Amy Jorgensen is coming back to lead this program for us. It's $5 to register. There is an additional $26 material fee that you'll bring with you to that first day of class. But you want to register, bring in your $5, save your seat for that one.
Everybody loves Amy, too. Amy's been at the Senior Center many times doing basket weaving with us in different capacities of weaving, I guess. Not always a basket, but she's a super instructor, too. And she kind of gets it started for us and then gives us the instruction on how to, you know, complete
Continue.
It. Yeah, but it definitely 2 days.
And it doesn't need to go on a bike. So if you have a walker, you can put it on there, or you can just set it down. It doesn't need to
How
go
cute.
On anything.
It could hang on a door,
it
right?
Could hang
put
on
some
a
spring
door.
Flowers in it.
You
Love
could.
It. Yeah, great,
so
great idea.
This one will fill, so make sure you register early for that one. Again, it's a two-part class, April 21st and the 28th. It starts at 9:30 and goes until 12:30 both of those days.
Very nice. Okay. Monday, April 25, we are going to get some training on emotional freedom, the emotional freedom technique, which is also called the acronym EFT, also known as tapping. So some of you might know tapping. Are you familiar with tapping, Erica? Have you done it before?
I've done it once.
Okay.
And it's one of those things that once you do it once, you want to do it again. You want to continue. It's kind of like if you ever go to get a massage. You always want to, you want to make the time to do it again. So definitely on my to-do list.
Well, Kathy Housie, who has been at our center many times, she's a phenomenal speaker, always bringing in new and relevant cutting edge information to share with us. She'll be coming in Monday, April 25, 11 o'clock to noon. And she is sponsored by Westwood Inn Senior Living. Tapping, just to give you guys a little inkling of what it is usually something that will reduce your stress or your anxiety, or even put some of the some other issues at bay. So it starts with like your statement. Like if you're feeling overwhelmed, you would start tapping, and there's different meridian points in your body that you tap in. And the premise is there are clogs in your meridian points. The flow of energy that's going through your body is clogged in certain areas. So tapping on them and releasing those, the anxieties that you have by saying certain words helps to let that flow without any of that clog. So like, if you're feeling overwhelmed, you would start on some meridian point like this. I'm feeling overwhelmed. And you repeat that. And then you go through all your different meridian points, top of your head, like the side of your face, your chin, different areas. And you say, I'm feeling overwhelmed. I'm feeling overwhelmed. And then at the end, you say, I'm feeling overwhelmed, but I love and accept myself. And then slowly, all of that anxiety, those nervous feelings that you have, or even some other like autoimmune issues, ADD, things like that can be relieved. Another great thing to have in your arsenal to combat things in a healthy, natural way. And you know, we love that. So put the pills down and start tapping. Learn how to do it on Monday, April 25th. We really want you to utilize that skill.
And it's a great skill. Like I said, I've done it once. But then once you kind of fall off, you need that reinstruction of really brings you back and refocuses and say, okay,
I can do this.
And then you just work it into your daily routine.
Yes.
So we're going to talk about stained glass.
Stained glass, everybody loves it.
We're starting a new rotation. So stained glass happens every Monday, but they're in 5-week sessions. Mm-hmm. So that way you have your project start to finish. So then everybody's kind of on the same schedule there. She's starting up a new class on April 25th. It's $25 to register for that class.
5-week class.
For the 5-week class, mm-hmm. Yeah. So it's not $25 each for the whole thing.
Yes.
It's $25. Sometimes there is a specific material that you might need to bring to class with you. So when you register, always make sure that you ask the ladies up front if there's any additional fees or if there's an additional supply that you may need to bring. There are very limited number of seats. This is a very popular thing, very popular class. So make sure that you register early. It is open to all skill levels. So if you've never done stained glass before, if you want to check it out, it's a great time to do so. If you're more expert in that area, she can always help you kind of explore different opportunities.
Sure. Yeah, Anita's a great instructor. She's been with us for quite a while now, and she will work with you at your skill level. And everybody walks away at the end of their 5-week professional, you know, and with their masterpiece. So it's always amazing to see how proud everyone is, and stained glass, every kind of piece, whether it's stained glass or a 3D flower or even mosaics with pieces of glass. It's just amazing what people produce. And you know, some people go on and sell them at craft shows.
Yeah.
So
it's a new tool.
Yeah. Could be your new side gig.
It's one of those, you always want to try something new. Keep your brain fit. It's a good time to
absolutely
give you something new to try.
Okay. I hope you have your calendar, because you're really going to want to mark this day. Wednesday, April 27. Let's see. Where's my prop? Okay. So when might I wear such a lovely hat, Erica?
I can only think of one thing, and that is a very classy tea party.
That's right, baby. We're going to have a high tea event, and that's Wednesday, April 27th from 12 o'clock to 2 o'clock. We'll have Story Point Senior Community will be sponsoring this amazing event, and they're bringing in their hat expert. So this lady, her name is Lori. She's going to have like a hat fashion show dating all the way back to the 1780s. of the different styles of hats and what their purposes were, who wore them, men, women, etc. And that we're also going to have, of course, we're going to have tea and tea-like edibles. So that's all going to be scrumptious. If you have a hat, please wear it. And if you have a teacup, please bring it, because we're going to be serving tea. We'll have, our cups if need be, but we would love for you to bring one of your heirloom teacups in, and definitely dress for the day, because who doesn't love a tea party? Wednesday, April 27, 12 to 2. Anytime Care, Home Care, is also sponsoring this. So we will tip our hat to those sweet sponsors for bringing in this amazing event. Looking forward to that.
And if you don't have a teacup and you really want a teacup, there's always teacups in the Hidden Treasures gift shop.
Most definitely.
That way you don't even have to buy a whole set. You can just get your one.
Get the one.
But don't wait until the day of, because there probably yeah. won't be any left.
It's going to be popular.
Everyone's going to be thinking the same thing.
It will be popular. And then I want to remind everybody that we have a grief share support group that happens on Tuesday evenings from 6 o'clock to 8 o'clock. This is sponsored by, or facilitated actually, by Resurrection Cemetery. So Michelle will take your reservation at 586-416-3310. Call to let her know you're coming. It's a series of different topics they explore weekly, but you can pop in at any time and continue to stay. Sometimes people stay beyond the one series of a few weeks and, hang out until they offer support to the new people coming in. So it's a really great group of comrades who share grief, share how to overcome grief, and learn how to move on with their lives. So
it's a great support system.
Real important group there. Mark your calendars for that if you're in need, or share it with anyone who you think might be in need. That's also free. No month is complete without talking to Matt Makowski in our trip board. So we're going to hand it off to Matt Makowski, and he is going to share with you some of the upcoming trips showing up.
Hello, I'm Matt Makowski. I'm the director of the Senior Center, and I am here to tell you about the different travel options that we have over at the Senior Center. If you haven't traveled with us before, it's absolutely phenomenal, and I'll tell you why. Because generally, when I'm traveling with my wife, I have to, get out a map and, do the driving and all that kind of stuff. With our travel, you don't have to worry about that. You just catch the bus here at the Clinton Township Civic Center, and we'll take you to where you need to go, right to the door. You don't have to worry about parking. You don't have to worry about traveling and maps and, do we have the tickets? All of our tours have travel people, travel representative on each coach. So we do travel by motor coach, and those are those big buses with the big, beautiful windows you can get on. They're climate controlled. A lot of them have Wi-Fi as well. Big window, so you can just sit back, recline your seat, and enjoy the ride. So if you're going as a single or a couple or a triple, it's always a great time on the bus. Even if it's raining outside, it's always sunny inside. So I'm going to tell you about a few of the trips that we have going on. All of our trips are listed on the Clinton Township website for the Senior Center Department, as well as we have flyers, and that's what I'm holding up here. We have flyers that are available in the lobby of the Senior Center. We're there from 8:30 to 4:30 p.m. Monday through Friday. You can always pick up a flyer, okay? So I'm going to start with the Ark Encounter and More. And I've got my notes because there's so many details. I want to make sure that I touch on a lot of the stuff. So the Ark Encounter, if you've never been to the Ark Encounter, it is a really cool trip. I went there for a little time a couple years ago, and on the way, we're going to go by motor coach, and then you will have all your accommodations are included. They're going to have 5 meals total, so those are all included. You're going to go on a Cincinnati dinner cruise. So there's a buffet dinner, and you're going to cruise the skyline of Cincinnati. Very nice. It's a Victorian decor, and we've been on it before, so people have really enjoyed it. Then you're going to go down to the Ark Encounter, which is in Williamston, Kentucky. And this ark is actually built to the specifications that they had in the Bible. So it's 510 feet long, 85 feet wide, and 51 feet high. And it It really is amazing. You get on these little trams, and as you drive up, you just come upon this humongous ark. And they have animals, and you get to tour the ark, and it's really amazing. So you will enjoy that. We're also going to go to the Creation Museum in Petersburg, Kentucky, and the Newport Aquarium. So for $5.99 per person, that includes that and more. So please pick up a flyer. That's with Rybicki Tours. They're a local company that we've dealt with for over 20 years. They do a great job for us, and we're very confident. Activity level, so it's about 3 out of 5 stars. So there's a little bit of walking, especially with the ark and those types of things. So if you're interested in that, that's going to happen on April 12th through the 14th. So get your deposit in, and we'll go from there. The next trip that I'm going to talk about is on April 23rd, and that is Blue Man Group, and that's going to be at the Fox Theater with Rybicki Tours as well. It's going to be departing at 10 a.m. and getting back by 5:15. It's going to include, of course, your motor coach transportation, as well as lunch at the Traffic Jam and Snug. If you've never been at Traffic Jam and Snug, it's a very eclectic place in Detroit, and you'll be dropped off right at the door, escorted right into the building. And it's not only a restaurant, but it's a dairy. They make their own cheeses and things. It's a brewery, and it's also a bakery. So they've got all kinds of stuff. And in the summer, they grow a lot of their herbs and vegetables on the rooftop. So it's really a cool place to go to. You will have your choice of 6 entree options. And then 2 main floor tickets at the Fox. Motor coach transportation is along with Rybicki Tours, and there will be a tour guide as well. So for $149, which is not bad, main floor seating, transportation, don't have to worry about parking, and then Traffic Jam and Snug, which is really cool. Rybicki's also providing us with a tour to Nashville, Tennessee. If you've always wanted to go to Nashville, this is your opportunity. May 2nd through the 5th, your accommodations are provided. The transportation is motor coach as well. 5 meals total are going to be included. You're going to get a Nashville City tour, go to the Wild Horse Saloon, the Ryman Auditorium, the Grand Old Opry Show, and historic RCA Studio B Tour, and the Country Music Hall of Fame. And if you've ever been to Nashville, you always want to go to the Lower Broadway. It's downtown, and it's considered the honky-tonk highway, so you'll have time to visit there. $1,099 per person, and if you need more information, flyers are available in the lobby. And then on to Fox Theater, if you're into theater. We are also going to have on May 8th, An American in Paris. So it's a musical. The composers are George and Ira Gershwin. So you're going to hear a lot of the classics, like I Got Rhythm and It's Wonderful. So if you're into that kind of music, we're also going to go to Traffic Jam and Snug with that, so you get your transportation, Fox Theater, main floor seating, lunch, and a tour guide for $145 on May 8th, which is a Sunday. You don't have to be a Senior Center member to join with the tour, so if you want to bring a son, daughter, a grandson, granddaughter, a friend from wherever, feel free to join us. We would love to have you on that. So, a couple more that we're going to touch on. May 18th, we're going to go to the Solanas Casey Center in Detroit. It's going to be from 9 a.m. to 3:45 in the afternoon. Transportation's included, and you will pick up the bus here at the Clinton Township Senior Center. You will go down to the Solanas Casey Center, take a tour of the Solanas Casey Center with a docent. There will be a catered lunch there for you, a time for the gift shop, and you can explore the center on your own. So, and a tour guide, obviously. $74 per person. And that will fill up fast. So if you'd like to join us at Solanas Casey, come on out and give us a deposit. Last but not least, May 18th through the 20th is the Kentucky Derby Experience. It's not the Derby itself, but it's everything that is encompassed in the Derby. So we're going to go by transportation with the motor coach, and that's with Ed and Ted's Excellent Adventures. Ed does a phenomenal job. He always goes on the trips himself. He's the owner. Saturday Night Fever is the Derby dinner show that you will be included in your ticket. The Frazier Museum, Louisville Slugger Bat and Factory and Museum, And I have to read these because there's so much stuff on here. Kentucky Derby Museum, they are going to have someone, a professional handicapper, come in and talk about tips and betting. So you'll know all the ins and outs of how to do that. And then dinner in the Millionaire's Row, and then a live thoroughbred racing at Churchill Downs. So a lot of meals included in this. It is a $50 deposit and $599 per person double occupancy. Okay, well, thanks for listening about the different programs, the travel programs that we offer at the Senior Center. And we're going to take it back to Debbie and Erica. So have a great day.
And thank you, Matt. Those are all great opportunities and great places to go see and explore. So make sure you stop by, give us a call if you have any questions about those, to get registered and signed up for those as soon as possible before they sell out. And it would not be complete without talking about one of our most attended programs that we have every single week, and that is bingo.
Yep.
So I just wanted to remind everyone that this is open to the public. You do not need to be a member to attend this. It is open for everyone. It's a $2 admission fee for everyone, and that gives you one bingo card.
That's your admission card, and then you can buy more cards for, I think, $1.
$1 or a quarter,
yep.
For those additional cards.
Some people have, like, their whole table in front of them filled with cards.
That.
And then, you know, I mean, it's all at whatever pace you want to be at playing bingo, so.
There is also a 50-50 that takes place at that bingo, mm-hmm. So if you're feeling extra lucky that day,
yep.
You can definitely put in for that 50-50. The other 50 that's not going to bingo players goes back directly to us at the Senior Center to be able to provide more programs that like we talked about today.
We appreciate that.
The first Friday of every month, we do have Orchards of Michigan coming in to do some blood pressure screenings.
Yep.
It's a good tool to have, especially if you're not regularly checking in with your doctor, checking
that
blood pressures just to make sure. It can get pretty heated at bingo, so we want to make sure that everyone
is. Yeah, we do the blood pressure before bingo starts because we know, like, at the end of bingo, there'll be, you know, a big variance of where you probably are naturally.
Yeah. So if you're running a little high at the beginning, you might want to maybe reduce it down to one card.
Oh, gosh. So that's about it on April, you guys. I know that it's a lot. I hope you had your calendar and your pen going while we were talking. You can pop in anytime and pick up a newsletter if you didn't receive one in the mail already. We'd love to say hi to you. Come say hi to Erica, our new sweetheart programmer. And until then, Erica, it's been great. We'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.